Yes, obviously, very disappointed not being able to close this game out. We got outplayed in the second half. You can point to any aspect of the team, offense, defense, or special teams, where we had opportunities to execute and didn't do it for 60 minutes. And obviously, some hidden yards and special teams was a factor. We had opportunity to win the game, but we never did it done so. Very, very disappointed, especially for our seniors' last game in the woodshed. Really appreciate our fans coming out on the day. It was pretty chilly, and we had a really good crowd, and we really appreciate that. But certainly disappointed. We got one game left. I know our guys are going to show up ready to practice and prepare for the last opportunity, but certainly very disappointed. A lot of people know what said about it, so I'll open up for questions.
Now, can you talk about their two kickoff returns and your missed field goals?
What about them?
What happened on the kickoff returns, and are you getting ready for the field goal at the end of regulation? Were you trying to get the ball in the middle of the uprights, or it looked like it went to the left?
Yeah, so on the kickoff return, they hit us with a couple of field returns. We didn't have really good levels to the field. In the first one, we lost leverage with a couple of guys. Ball got outside of us, and the same thing happened in the second half. So it was a field return that we didn't execute. And then, yeah, at the end there, we had an opportunity to end it with a field goal. Ran the ball. We were trying to get it as close to the middle field as we could. Called timeout with 3 seconds, and we missed it to the left. So.
Mel, that last drive in particular, can you kind of walk through? Are you trying to run the clock down as far as you can at that point? It seemed like you guys were getting out of whether to pass, whether to run on a couple of those plays. What was the communication situation at that point?
So we were trying to score a touchdown. We had a couple of timeouts. We want to make sure we have the right plays. We had a situation, at the end of the Illinois game, as you guys can remember, and they didn't have any timeouts, and we were trying to score touchdowns, so we didn't want to leave it up to a field goal team. So this game, we were down there pretty tight. They didn't have any timeouts, and so we were trying to score a touchdown, and we ran them one last time, see if we could pop one through. They didn't have any timeouts, and we didn't score on that third down, so we ran. They didn't have a way to stop the clock, so we ran the whole way down, called timeout with 3 seconds, and we missed a field goal. So. We weren't initially playing for a field goal. It really didn't make sense for us to try to do that. But ultimately, that's what happened. So we didn't make it. And so it was a lack of execution. So that's pretty much what happened. We did want to make sure we had the right plays called. Everybody was on the same page. We didn't have a timeout remaining, so we were able to get that done.
Matt, I'm all in the middle here. They came in averaging on like 85 yards or so per game rushing. They do anything differently on the ground, and how much, I guess, did their quarterback change affect what you guys were able to do?
I don't think they did anything differently. Again, like some of our perimeter run support, we got outflanked. I really didn't see the first run, the first couple of runs they popped up, we have to see those. It seems like we kind of got outflanked, over into the boundary. We kind of didn't get bumped over, moved over as far as we can. So something. He settled down, started getting stopped, and pretty much shut it down for a while, and then it popped another one. One of our guys got caught up inside, fell down, and we spilled the ball outside, and we didn't have a hat there to make the play, so it went four ways, but it wasn't anything that, you know, that they did that was unexpected. We just didn't plan properly. So when the quarterback run game was always gonna be tough. A little stress on our ends. Cut to keep situations. And so thought we did a good job in some instances with some pressures to create some times for loss and some things to try to mitigate those situations. But obviously they popped that one in the second half. It was a killer for us. We were able to get them settled down after that. We don't have margin for error. We can't allow them to happen. We can't allow them to, you know, pop a run and then settle down after that. You know, then pop another run later and settle down. We can't get them anything. So.
Steven, going off that a little bit. You guys haven't played a lot of heavy QB run teams or a lot, very many mobile QBs. Do you think just a lack of experience against that style of player had much to do with it? And also, I'm wondering with your quarterback, I saw Peyton was getting to play from the sideline a lot today, and you guys usually sit. I'm just wondering what was behind that.
Well, Peyton getting the call from the sideline, that was by design. I'm not sure if I really want to go into why. It's probably not a good idea for me to go into why we did that, but that was intentional on our part. That was the game plan going in.
Gotcha.
That's not something that we normally do.
Right. What about defensively? Do you think there's a lack of experience against a QB who can move like that maybe played a factor?
I wouldn't say it was a lack of experience. I mean, we played some guys, some quarterbacks this year that were mobile. You know, obviously you have to be able to get guys on the ground, you have to be able to make tackles. Usually when you have a mobile quarterback, you're going to be in a one-on-one tackling situation. So you have to be able to, win those one-on-one battles with guys. We were able to get them on the ground sometimes, sometimes we weren't. And our tackling really needs to improve, overall. And we have to get more guys at the point of attack, because we can't really leave it up to just one guy to make a tackle one-on-one. The way we're built, we need to get multiple guys on the ball to really be able to get them stopped.
Coach, because of their success with the kick return, were there any thoughts on changing up your strategy on trying to shut that down, or did you feel you had the right place to take care of that coming in?
We tried, we did a couple of different types of kicks, and that was effective. So we did what we could to try to change it up. But we're not exactly sure, all the time when we kick the ball where it's going to go. So that's a little bit of an issue for us.
Anything else for Coach? Matt?
Bigger picture here, I'm just, in one score games, you've been really successful here. To see the position you were in, up 17.2, look at the numbers, 2-1 in total yards, essentially. I guess, can you kind of sum up what this team has to do to bounce back? I mean, they've had a lot of bouncing back all the year, but just the way this game went, the kind of defeated feeling of the way it went, how do you overcome that?
Yeah, I mean, it's a little different. Like when we're on the inside, when we're on the team, on the staff, fix it. You know, as long as everyone understands what needs to be done, we fix it, we make the correction, we move on, trying to make sure it doesn't happen again. But, you know, anytime you lose, it hurts the same, you know, so. It's either do that or just quit and just say, listen, you know, we're just going to like pack it in. I don't know how else to handle it. Fix it, move on, or go in the tank and, you know, feel sorry for yourself and, you know, be soft and, you know, just, you know, be a non-competitor and just, get the poor knees and, somebody feel sorry for them, it's not going to happen, so I don't think that's going to happen here. So we just got to buckle up, block out the noise. Like I told you guys, we got to block out the noise, because there's going to be a lot of it, just like it has been, you know, all season and then going forward. So that's like, that takes mental toughness, it takes character. I think this team has shown that we do have that.
Especially for a guy like Elijah, stuck through everything to go for more than 100 and two touchdowns today, which is what you saw in the run game overall.
Yeah, the run game has been, you know, consistent in the past, you know, few games where we've been able to get room in the run game. And it's been more than just one back. And it's been more than just one type of run. So our guys are understanding the scheme a lot better, where the ball needs to hit. They're doing a really good job, you know, blocking the plays. Tight ends are doing a really good job, doing a better job in the run game, and the receivers, they're a big part of that. And then obviously, you know, when we do have an opportunity to check out some plays, you know, Peyton does a really good job of recognizing the fronts and seeing pressures coming. Make sure we're getting into the right place. So we've been fairly consistent in the past few weeks of being able to run the ball. So we knew that we'd be able to run it today. We knew we'd be able to throw it as well. We feel like we've got to move the ball. You know, all these guys consistently, based on what we saw on tape. Not taking anything away from them. They're really good players. They're big up front. They're well coached. They play hard. We felt like we could match that and be able to execute and move the ball, which we were able to do. So in the second half, I'm going to need more points, and we got to do a better job on special teams. Obviously, we thought special teams would be the difference in this game, and absolutely, and it worked. We thought we do better.
The rebound you've had the last couple of weeks and the comebacks that you've had, you know, last year especially, how surprised were you to see the team kind of unravel like it did in the third quarter?
Nothing really surprises me. I mean, it comes down to execution, you know, so guys were playing hard and we had our moments, you know. But there's not that much difference between us and most of the teams that we play. You know, some of the teams we play, maybe a difference in depth or talent wise, but most of the teams that we play is fairly evenly matched, and it does come down to, you know, field position, you know, special teams, you know, a big play here and there. And so it's not a matter of unraveling. This is just a matter of the margins are very slim. And so you can look really good one minute, and you can look really bad the next. Next minute, just because of it's just that close. So you know, one guy doesn't do what he's supposed to do on kickoff coverage, and that's we don't have a lot of margin for error. So if one guy doesn't do his job, you know, it's a touchdown. You know, so that's what it is. It's not a matter of lack of effort. Guys not. In general, not knowing what to do. I mean, it's where we are. We have to be like perfect, you know, most of the time to be able to execute, you know, in this conference. And when we're not, we don't look very good, and that's what happened. You know, we moved the ball in the second half. We got them stopped in the second half as well sometimes, but just they made more plays, and so. You guys have been asking me all season, is it execution? Well, we turn on the film, we heard you said before, it's going to be death by inches. That's what it's going to be. We turn on the film. I'm going to go back to the office right after this. I'll turn the film off. I was going to bomb it because my block missed here, when I got out of this layup kickoff here, you know, missed field goal here. This tackle, I mean, that's what it is. So that's why we got to come back ready to work, you know, tomorrow to try to eliminate, you know, all mistakes and have a higher level of execution on a consistent basis. And I don't have any doubt that our guys will do that, because that's what we've always done. Very high character guys, and our guys have shown that they can respond to adversity, you know, pretty much all season, but our guys know how to respond, so they have perspective.